Music has always been a part of my life that helps me deal with the stress of life. Some people have like comfort food. Music is my comfort food.
Choral music in high school was sort of like my saving grace. It really saved my life, and it was the first time that I felt like I belonged somewhere.
Well, music has always been kind of a survival thing for me throughout my childhood, which was not a very pleasant place to be, and I always used music as a way to kind of rise above it and to get past the day-to-day angst of being a kid.
I needed to bring music back into my life, and I also needed to do something in the gay community. One of my friends said, well, see if there's a gay men's chorus, and I was like, why would there be a chorus of gay men? Oh, there is a chorus of gay men. Cool.
Well, I've been a member of the chorus since before the earth cooled. I joined 35 years ago after I'd come out of a straight marriage and needed a place where I could bring my daughters and let them come out as having a gay father.
It was when I got sober in 2013 that I found myself at a 12-step meeting, and someone was talking about how excited they were to be auditioning for the Twin Cities Gay Men's Chorus, and I knew that that was something that I wanted to be a part of. So I got Ben Riggs' information from that person. I emailed Ben that night and scheduled an audition the next day. Getting into the Twin Cities Gay Men's Chorus was coming home and realizing that I had a place where I belonged and where I could really kind of start to explore who it is that I am and really embrace being myself.
When you're not in a group of people who are gay like you, you can feel like an outsider. You can feel on your own island a little bit, like you can't relate to some people. But when you're with the chorus, you have this common thread that's among every single person in the room.
I had a hard time when I decided to join the chorus because I was worried that my artistic self of being in musicals would get lost because I didn't keep up with my craft, thinking that it didn't transfer. But the truth is, I've had more enriching artistic experiences being a part of the Twin Cities Gay Men's Chorus that it made me a better musical theater actor, and I actually haven't gone back in 4 years because the production and the elegance of what we do from concert to concert to concert keeps me coming back for more.
You know, like every concert that I've been to has been just all of the emotions, you know, like the happy, the sad, the crying, the joyful, the proud. They do a really good job from a musicality standpoint, and then also just kind of really connecting with their audience.
The community outreach is probably my favorite part. A good example would be last year we went to Avalon High School over in St. Paul, and that was when we were practicing our Two Boys Kissing set. I remember delivering this speech that my character had about your body and loving your body, no matter what it is. And there was a trans child sitting right in front of me, crying because what I was saying was speaking to them.
I think there are young people everywhere that still need to be able to see themselves somewhere that they are not represented in their life. I think that all of the voices need to be heard all of the time. And just because the fight for something is not actively happening does not mean you can stop relaying an important message, because there's always going to be people that are going to need to hear that. There's always going to be people that need to see men who are not afraid to be who they are in a group of people so that they know that there's somewhere they can go.
I've never met somebody who has told me it's easy being gay. That doesn't seem to be the thing. And I want my children to grow up in a time where that can be the goal, that we can get to a place where whether, you know, my boys turn out to be gay or straight or whatever they end up being as adults, that they can feel safe and that they can have a place. And I want that for everybody.
I think there is a danger when we make advances in civil liberties to become complacent and not think that there's still not a fight to wage, that there's still not people out there that still fear things that they don't understand. And that's why groups like the Twin Cities Gay Men's Chorus is so important. I think actually even more important when we think things are going really well, because there's still a fight and there's still folks that don't understand us as people. And the chorus can really build a bridge that then the rest of us can walk on, and that's what they do.
I think that there's a whole other component to the Gay Men's Chorus that sometimes people don't necessarily know about, and that is the outreach that you guys do. And that is not necessarily always supported by buying tickets to go see a show. To be able to take the Gay Men's Chorus and send them somewhere where people need to hear their voices in a way that's not necessarily in a giant concert hall surrounded by a bunch of other people that already know and love and appreciate the the Gay Men's Chorus and are a part of the gay community, that is where they need money. I think that's where people come in a nonprofit. But if you can really do a, what is it called, a cost to benefit ratio, is that what that is? And say, how much is $10 worth? How much is $100 worth? If a person gets to hear something they've never heard before, and you could say, they found themselves. They found a place where they see who they are and they can be supported and they know there's somewhere they're going to be able to go. That's where that comes in. That's why I'd give money.
One of the things about donating to any nonprofit is that it doesn't matter what you give, it's that you do give. Because even if you give, you know, $50 and that's all you can, you know, do, or you do $5 a month or whatever, you know, kind of makes sense to you as a person, you are demonstrating what you think their value is to you. And also you're supporting the people that are part of the community, that are part of the chorus, and giving them that space so that they can kind of be their true selves. The chorus has been doing that for 36 years now, and I think that it's a really special kind of place. It's based on a common shared interest. And, you know, in addition to having the background in the gay men's movement, there's also that art. And I think that combination is really unique. And that's not something that can kind of just happen outside of this space. And so I think we need to continue to support it.